Hello, continuing on with the PRMS training video series. I'm talking about the snow comp module here. This satisfies the snow process, and this is the only module, so there's no choice. This module develops a snowpack, simulates the accumulation depletion process, and computes the energy for melting the snow, and that's what we're going to go through. So, properties of snow. Snow is a porous media. Snow does change through time. The albedo changes with time. The density increases with time. And snow does have the ability to store melted water, free water. So in PRMS, we model the snowpack as a two-layered system. Since PRMS runs on a daily time step, we divide the day into two 12-hour periods, basically night and day, the warm period and the cold period. The snowpack exchanges heat between the two layers and also mass, basically in the form of liquid water, moves down through the top to the bottom. The temperature of this surface layer is based on the air temperature. It's either the air temperature or zero if the air temperature is above zero. And then the temperature in the pack, the majority of the snow down here, is actually computed with a heat balance. If you took this whole depth of snow and melted it, that would be the pack water equivalent depth. Okay, so what are the steps, the computational steps for the snowpack on each HRU? Basically, the first thing that happens is any new precipitation is added to the snowpack. Then the snow-covered area is computed based on the pack water equivalent. Albedo is computed, the depth, and that's the actual depth. Pack density is computed. The energy for the night, the energy for the day, then sublimation, and finally any melted ice is computed. So precipitation falling on a snowpack. If snow falls and a pack doesn't exist yet because no snow has fallen or whatever snow there was is melted, then a new pack is initiated. And if rain falls, it's added as melted water to the pack. You can see there's a few parameters, free H2O, and this example here, you can see we've got some liquid water inside of our snowpack. All right, depletion curves. These are pretty important to PRMS. Along the x-axis, we've got the fractional amount of snow water equivalent, and then on the y-axis, we've got the snow-covered area. You really are concerned about this once the pack moves into the melt phase during the melt season, or anytime the pack is melting. Basically, you start out here and you move in towards having less pack water equivalent and less amount of snow covered area as the pack melts off. And really the idea here is to describe the driftiness and the patchiness of the snow. And if you think about it, like if an inch of snow falls on a parking lot and the sun comes out, it's all going to melt off in one day. But if that same amount of snow gets plowed up into a big snowbank, that, you know, that could last weeks or months. The same volume, it's just this relationship between snow water equivalent and snow covered area is different, and it really determines how things melt off. So here's an example of a couple different shapes of depletion curves. And typically if you have a forested area, your snow covered area can go all the way up to 100% cover because the trees can keep the snow from drifting. In the case of alpine above timberline, a lot of times no matter how much snow you'll get, you still have patchiness because the wind will redistribute the snow into snow banks. Another important aspect of the snow module in PRMS is this idea of albedo, which is basically the reflectiveness of the snow. So the whiter and the more reflective the snow is, the less solar radiation, shortwave radiation, less effect that energy is going to have on the snowpack because it's reflected away. And you see a real difference here. This plot is showing that the reflectiveness is much lower during the melt period than it is when the snow is fresh white and finer crystals. And so once the snow starts melting, it melts a lot faster because it absorbs more energy. And you can see the idea how PRMS is doing this. The number of days since the last time it snowed, basically, once you're in the melt phase or if you're in the accumulation phase up here. Here's some equations from the PRMS user's manual. You can see these bold den init and den max. Those are parameters. And what we're trying to do is compute the actual pack depth. It's not the water equivalent, but that's the actual depth of the snow. So this describes basically how the snow is settling through time. If you've got an aging snowpack, that's what this delta pack depth is. So PRMS is computing the actual depth of the snow. Getting ready to look at some of the energy equations in PRMS. You can see all the different terms we take into account in the energy balance. This is kind of the full energy equation, all the different, I'm not going to go through all this, but you can see there's all these different sources of heat that can be putting heat into the snowpack for our melting snow. If these terms are negative, then it's going to be heat moving out of the snowpack and the snowpack actually getting colder. So in some form or another, you have to kind of keep track of all this stuff. When we're looking at the heat through conduction, that was one of the terms in the previous equation. We're using this formulation from Anderson. It's a temperature index. Basically, if you give it the temperature, it'll tell you the heat being conducted into or out of the snowpack according to this. And all this stuff is the thermal conductivity. If we look at these terms, so here's the basic form of the energy balance when the pack is in melt. We're getting ready to melt some snow. This first term here is the shortwave radiation. And so we've got this equation, which the DD or CC sol rad, this albedo term, depending on how long it's been since it snowed. And then here's a parameter here, rad transmission coefficient. Solve this. This gives you this heat shortwave term. The heat longwave term is this. Down here you can see it's kind of a black body type idea where the air and the vegetation and the snow itself is emitting longwave radiation. And those were those different terms come from. This is condensation and evaporation terms. So there's different forms depending on if you've got a lot of moisture in the air based on the fact if it's precipitating or not. The amount of heat that's in the precip. Basically, if it's raining on a snowpack, we assume the rain is coming down at the temperature of the air. And then this final term is the conduction from the snowpack to the ground. And in PRMS, we assume the snowpack and the ground are at the same temperature, which is usually a pretty good assumption. So if you're really interested in this kind of stuff, I suggest you go read the user's manual where these things are really spelled out in a lot more detail. Once you've got all your heat figured out, that's this term here, TCal, the number of calories going into the snowpack And here you can see snow-covered areas. So we're only melting snow where there is snow, right? So that's what this equation is about here. Sublimation. Okay, so here's the snow evap equation from the PRMS user's manual. Here's a parameter, POTT sublim, the sublimation parameter, and these other terms are being computed either by other modules or further up the chain in this module. And that's the end.